For those of you who may not know, the original 10th anniversary of Doctor Who was not going to be the Three Doctors, at least as we know it, written by Dave Martin and Bob Baker, with the Three Doctors overcoming the Time Lord evil being Omega. What the original premise of the anniversary special would have been was that the Three Doctors would have been trying to conquer death itself, death incarnate, and playing a bunch of games with the devil. However, when it became apparent that William Hartnell was not as well as they were led to believe in early conversations, they decided to change the idea of the story, they decided to change the premise of it to make it a bit more functional, you know, lower the budget down a little bit, and also make sure that William Hartnell was involved, but via a distance, and that's how we got into those monitors in that story, in that four-part story from the 70s. However, because of Big Finish Productions, and they have their own group of Doctor Impressionist actors with Tim Traylor, with Michael Troughton, and Stephen Noonan playing Doctors 3, 2, and 1 respectively, and also John Coleshaw as the Brigadier, we have now got a brand new version of this original pitch for the Three Doctors, Death World, adapted by John Dorney for Big Finish Productions, and directed by David A. Mahoney. So the premise of Death World is that the actual embodiment of death, voiced by Joe Shire, and also the Madam President of the Time Lords, voiced by Diane Pilkington, are basically across a chessboard from each other, very similar to Ingmar Bergman's Seventh Seal, and Death is wanting to imbue his reign over Gallifrey and the Time Lords, and Madam President does not want that to happen to her people, so she enlists her three champions, these three incarnations of the Doctor, in order to stop Death. So Death sends a bunch of zombies to attack Unit HQ in the 1970s. Tim Traylor as the Third Doctor is there. We've got Katie Manning reprising her role as a Joe Grant, and we've got John Coleshaw as the Brigadier. And they are trying to stave off an invading army of zombies from Unit HQ. The Doctor's lab explodes and he's sent to parts unknown. The Second Doctor and Jamie also get caught up in a death-like shenanigans. The First Doctor as well. And they are all sent to the titular Death World, where they have a confrontation with Death itself. Let's play a clip from Death World.
This individual claims to be the personification of Death itself.
Oh, well, I suppose that makes the name of the place more egotistical than anything else.
I do not claim to be Death. I am Death. Saying so is merely a statement of fact.
A statement of the very future! Death is an abstract concept. It has no self, no identity.
And how would you know? You've defied me at every opportunity.
Twice at the last count.
I beg your pardon?
No. You don't mean...
I'm afraid so.
Well, that explains a lot.
So, you're my replacement, are you? A vagrant and a fop.
A fop? I wouldn't put it quite like that, sir.
Coming from an Edwardian schoolmaster?
How dare you?
Well, I'll have you know this is a height of couture.
Well, exactly.
That'll do, the pair of you. This is getting us nowhere.
Seems appropriate, given that's apparently where we are.
At least for the moment. Yes, limbo, you called it. Are you saying we're dead?
Dead? Oh, crumbs.
Not exactly.
I don't understand.
Well, if we had to explain everything you don't understand, we'd be here all day.
In the chat, Sarah Glover's asking who voices Death. It's Joe Shire, and the reason he sounds familiar is because he played Gideon in Torchwood Soho Ascension, who we also heard from in a clip in the last review. So that's likely why he sounds a bit familiar, but he's also got a brilliant voice. He's so good in this box set overall. Joe Shire has got this wonderful, like, effortless charm to him as Death, where, yeah, he's kind of been sold as, like, a big malicious figure, but there's some really friendly turns that he makes as an actor. And yeah, he's so terrific there as well. God, the actors playing the Doctors absolutely smashed it from that snippet. Yeah, they are so good, all three of them. I will kind of very gladly say that Death World is a terrific, like, Big Finish introductory story to these three Doctors. If you are a bit hesitant about listening to Big Finish classic Doctors from the 60s and the 70s, this is like a really easy sell. Kind of like how I find it to be a very easy recommendation for Out of Time, starring David Tennant and Tom Baker as the 10th and the 4th Doctor, respectively. Death World is a really solid, strong adaptation of a version of the Three Doctors that we never wound up getting. But honestly, I think I prefer Death World to the Three Doctors story that we actually got. And that's not me trying to discredit the Three Doctors, but I think that Death World is a much more interesting premise thematically, where you've got these incarnations of the Doctor, which, with the exception of the first one, of course, have managed to cheat death at some point, and death is now coming after them, and also coming after the Time Lords more broadly, and how you get these really cool pairings where you've got the first Doctor and the Brigadier. You have the second Doctor and Jamie, and the third Doctor and Joe, but the first Doctor and the Brigadier is genuinely an inspired pairing, where you've got this authority figure who has never met this incarnation of the Doctor before in any capacity. Like, he knows the second Doctor, but the second Doctor and Jamie don't recognize him, because it's pre-Web of Fear. It's pre the invasion for the Doctor and Jamie. They mention Victoria, so the Brigadier knows the Doctor, but the second Doctor doesn't know him, but he has no idea what the first Doctor is. And this cantankerous old guy in the blue box is just berating him at every opportunity, and it's a really fun dynamic. I think that all of the actors acquit themselves incredibly well to all of the roles. Tim Traylor, Michael Trout, and Stephen Newton, of course, they're all terrific. I think that the premise as well of having Death trying to chase down these different incarnations of the Doctor and these different pairings through different means, because you also have like the Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse, where you have pestilence, where you have famine. You also get the seven deadly sins as well in the story. The way that they get a lot of mileage out of the concept of death as an enemy, death made manifest, is really, really effective. There's a great set piece on a battlefield as well, where death takes the form of a commander, and they have to convince the soldiers that, you know, the commander is their real enemy. There's just some really, really cool ideas here. And I know that, like, Empire of Death, the latest season of Doctor Who's finale, tried to, like, make explicit the idea that the Doctor is, like, the god of life, opposed to Sutekh, the god of death, but Death World definitely keeps that more in the subtext, where you have these incarnations of the Doctor who are like gods of life and gods of hope, and they're literally fighting against death itself. It's a really cool, it's really cool thematically, and I love the conceit of part four as well. There's a, I won't give any spoilers away, but essentially the Doctors are on borrowed time, and how they start like facing their fears, how they start facing death and looking him metaphorically in the eye in what could be their last few minutes and their last few moments is really effective drama. There's some really wonderful camaraderie between the third and second Doctor, where of course they have this like rivalry on screen, yeah, fancy pants, scarecrow, you know, all of that stuff that is present, but how they lower their guard in part four, I thought it was really moving and really effective. Particularly how the companions react to the Doctors being on borrowed time as well with death. You know, the cast are really, really strong. Like I mentioned earlier, I think that Joe Shire as Death is absolutely terrific from start to finish, with a really multifaceted, charming portrayal of the skeletal figure with the scythe. I thought that was really great. Actors are really strong. There's a lot going on thematically here. Some really strong, great set pieces, borrowing from mythology. I loved this a lot. Yeah, this was really good. The more I think about it, the more I like it. It's put together really well. The performances are so strong. There's some great moments of dialogue and levity, some great interactions. That I love it when the third Doctor and Joe reunite in part two on this battlefield and the banter that they have. I think that's really lovely. I love how Jamie obviously has a crush on Joe and is trying to rescue her at every opportunity. I thought that was really fun. There's a great bit where the Brigadier and Jamie get obsessed with rescuing a damsel in distress. there's some really fun stuff here that you kind of expect from the UNIT family and like 1960s Doctor Who, where it's dealing with some serious and heavy themes, but it doesn't take them too seriously. I think that John Dorney's really worked wonders with the tone here, and that tone, along with the performances, is what makes Death World a very easy recommendation. I think that this is, like, if you've not heard any third, second, or first Doctor Adventures from Big Finish, or at least you've not heard any with these particular actors on board, I honestly can recommend diving into Death World. You know, it's one story, it's a four-parter, it moves along at a really good clip, the actors are superb and on top form, and then if you gravitate to any one of those three, then you can go and listen to them further. Like, you know, for the Second Doctor, I really recommend what they're doing with his, like, the Beyond War Games set with, like, Fraser Hines and Wendy Padbury. I really like what they're doing with Stephen Noonan's incarnation with these, the revisitations of the old companions. You know, there's a really, really strong run of Third Doctor Tim Treloar box sets that have been going on for years at this point. Yeah, Death World's really, really easy to get into. Oh, and Stephen Noonan is in the chat. Evening, William. Not heard much about this Death World thing, but rumour has it that for those who are rightly afraid of Doctor Who, they are spectacularly read quiz elsewhere on this channel. Oh, God, it was so funny in the behind... Stephen, have you heard the behind-the-scenes interviews for Death World yet, where somebody mentions that, Stephen Noonan's a really big fan of Doctor Who, and the other actors are like, oh, you only just found that out, you only just figured that out. Really fun. But yeah, Stephen, this is really good. I thought you were really, really great with John Corshaw as the Brigadier as well. You know, Third Doctor gets Joe, Second Doctor gets Jamie, First Doctor gets Brigadier. That's genuinely inspired. That's really clever. And yeah, Katie, yeah. Katie was brilliant as well at Hooverville this past weekend. Oh, she was so lovely. She stroked my beard and she called me a hunk. So I'm going to continue never washing this cheek again. Katie was lovely. She signed my season 10 and my season 8. You can see in the background there. Yeah, first time I've ever met Katie or properly interacted with her. It was very lovely. The queue to see Katie Manning at Hooverville was really, really long, not necessarily because of how many people were in the queue, but because Katie Manning gave everybody at the front of the queue like several minutes, like a proper conversation, like to talk to her and have like an interaction with her. She was brilliant. Yeah, she was absolutely lovely. It made my weekend.